Preparing to record. Oh, that's so pleasant. I don't know if you guys heard that. Okay. So, this is OreSat. And we're just going to go through the feature tree. And feel free to ask any questions. I guess I'll just kind of start with the... So, basically what we have here is an assembly of sub-assemblies. And so that just makes it easier to keep track of things, and then we can mate things separately. So like, for example, the battery card, all of these mates are done in an assembly off of this card itself. So you can see battery PCB is the part, and it's in battery holder 2, which is, I have to go back and fix that name. But so all of those mates are in this assembly, and then I only have to mate the card to the frame. So that's why we do sub-assemblies. And then that just makes it a lot easier to go through the feature tree. We have each of the cards named, and so you can go in, we'll move it so it's the correct orientation. So from top to bottom, you can theoretically go down. They're a little bit out of order, but you've got an end cap here. So you can see end cap with its PCB and all the little screws that are in it. So all of these. And then let's say we want to know what this card is. So we click on it, and oh, it's a positive end card, which makes sense because it's the positive Z side of the end card. And then you can basically just go down, and you can see that there's a GPS card and a C3 card and Star Tracker card in between, DX Wi-Fi card. So I don't know why it's hidden. That's weird. Oh, because I'm working on it. So yeah, each of them have their own little name, so that you can easily go to what you're looking for. And the only thing that is done a little bit differently is the reaction wheels. I think they're mated directly to the frame instead of the card, which is different from the other assemblies, and that's just how they are. And also the frames are done in their own assembly, so you can see frames here. So those weren't put in one at a time. They're all done in their own assembly. And they've got all of the wedges and triangles. And we use a lot of patterns. It's not really showing here. But instead of going in and doing like one and then another and another, we do a linear pattern. And then you can do a circular pattern, if that makes sense. Obviously not that way because the backplane, but in this positive X space, which I've taken off. And I'm just kind of winging it, so I'm just looking at what is interesting. And a lot of fasteners. So someone asked me this question, I think it was someone from UMBC, but these numbers here, so I think SolidWorks default is to have this kind of moved in. So if you're just looking at it in default mode, you'll just see these numbers. And we leave the McMaster car parts as they are named when you download them. And that's so if you are just quickly looking, you can see whether it's in your file explorer or in here, that's the part number. So you can just quickly Google it and find whatever you need to know about it. And you can also grab maybe the next size up. So it just makes it a little bit easier.
Always good practice. I've done it everywhere I've worked.
Cool. So yeah, good practice for everyone to just leave it like that. And so let's see, some important notes is, well, one, our coordinate system is off from what it actually is. I don't know who made this assembly. It's not me. But you can see that, like, all of the things I said before are kind of centered off the origin. So our right plane is not on the right side. It's in the center, which some people might not like because it's kind of not intuitive. If you think right plane, you want it to be on the right, but it just makes things a lot easier to mate. And so an example of that is if we've got this card here, the GPS card. So you can see I only had to do 3 mates to get this card in the frame. So I mated the right planes together and the front planes together, which are both in the center, so then the centers are aligned. And then I mated the bottom of the card to where it would hit the frame. So it's just a lot easier to get things centered that way. And because we, OreSat and CubeSats in general, have to be very centered in terms of their center of mass, and then we also have many components that need to be concentric. You can see that they're perfectly concentric, and those are two completely different sub-assemblies, so I didn't have to really mate them together. They're just mated separately, and so that just kind of gets rid of any like tolerance creeping. So that's pretty nice. And let's see, is there anything anyone wants to look at? Any questions? Okay, I guess I'll just go through and talk about some of what these things mean. We have these in a README on GitHub, but it might just be easier to talk about them. So frames are obviously these metal frames, pretty self-explanatory. That subassembly has all 4 frames, wedges and triangles, and the little fasteners, which is all of these, many, many things. And those are also done in a certain way so that if you change one thing of the frame, it can all change because they have to be mated together, obviously. So it makes things a little bit easier. Backplane assembly, so that is not only the PCB, but any of the connectors. It's a little bit outdated because we added more cards and it needs to be updated. It's not this, because those go in the card assembly, so not this part with all the little pins, but this part, which you can't really see very easily, but that is on the back plane, so this part right here. And then these RF connectors. So all of those, and then we fasten it in to the frames, so these fasteners, all of that. So that's the backplane assembly. And then we've got solar module. So 2 on each side. And that includes the PCB and then the solar panel and the fasteners. And also their connectors. So they connect in through here, these little guys, to the end cards. And so end caps are the cap, so the very last card is not actually a card, it's a cap, because it just kind of gets put down instead of slid in. So it's like putting a hat on it. So there's one on the positive Z side and the negative Z side. Those are the end caps, and those don't really have too much going on. What has the most going on out of the two is going to be the end cards. So we've got the positive end card here, which has Jim's helical, and all of that is assembled with the solar connectors. And then you can kind of go down, the GPS card is got the GPS on it, C3 card. DX Wi-Fi has OreSat Live. I don't know why it's not there. It is there, it's just not there today. Star tracker card has the camera that tracks the stars so we can know how we're aligned. We've got 2 battery holders, and they're missing their inhibit switches because they're under construction, but you can see the holes for them. So inhibit switches would go here through the positive X side. I like to cut through the positive X side just because that's how we look at it. The way that it's designed is that the positive X side goes on at the very end, like another little hat. So if you were to look at it sitting on the table, usually the positive X side is what is off. So I just cut through it because that's how we normally see it. And so that's why the inhibit switches go through that, because we would just slide it on to top of the inhibit switches, so they would go through the little hole. And so you can see that, like, the battery holders have that card, the holders, the batteries, and all of the fasteners. And lost my place. And then, like I said, the mounting brackets for the reaction wheels are the only ones that are done directly to the frames in this assembly because of how they need to be. So that's why they say mounting bracket instead of a card. They're done separately, done in their own assembly with all these little parts. And these are a little bit out of order, but negative Z end card is what has the Cirrus Fox cam. This is the tuna can, just to, as a visual reference. And it also has our turnstile antennas. So helical antenna on top for OreSat Live and turnstile antenna on bottom for communication purposes. And so that's the card. So Cirrus Flex camera is not connected to the end card. It just goes through it. So it has its own card here. And so this is the card for the reaction wheels and most likely the magnet workers as well. So it's just kind of hanging out on its own. Doesn't have too much going on right now. And then you've got some fasteners to keep things together. And then OTR card is also under construction, so it's just hanging out until we get more information from them. And then I also took out, as you can see, I try to keep things updated. I should take these out, actually. So there shouldn't be any wedges where there aren't cards, and for a while, even all the connectors were updated, but we've changed things, so they need to be updated again so that we can get a really accurate information on the mass when we put in all the material properties. And so the other thing to note is that McMaster car downloads, so all of these screws do not come with any material properties, so you have to go put them in manually. And yeah, so little solar folder. And then these down here, this coordinate system was for the reaction wheels. Corey wanted a coordinate system kind of in line with them, so you can see they're at an angle. So I made one of those. And that's how it works. That's the big overall view of OreSat. Does anyone have any questions or anything they want to look at? No.
Katie, you mentioned the triangles on the frames. What is that part?
Yes, so OreSat has, well, backing up a little bit. So OreSat is a little bit unique in its design. We use a card bus system, so the cards slide in rather than most CubeSats, which have them stacked. So they would have, we used to have it in for CFC, but these cards would be kind of separated by standoffs and then bolted vertically. So that's, they stack them in most CubeSats, which can be a little bit difficult because then you have to kind of unscrew everything if you want to change them. So we have a bus system where all of the cards communicate through the backplane. So the backplane is a PCB, which is why it's purple, and they all communicate through the connectors, which have like two pins with two inside of them, so four total for backups, which if Andrew is on the call, I think that's correct. And so in case for a vibration, we're not losing that connection to the backplane, so it's really sturdy. And then the issue with sliding them in comes, okay, well, they're supposed to be 1.6, but maybe they're a little bit wavy based on how they were made. And so you can get some tolerancing errors. And so it was just kind of hard to get them to slide in perfectly the same for all of them because they're not going to be perfectly the same. So someone, Joe, Andrew, I don't remember. This was right as I was coming in. They came up with this wedge system. And Let me cut through a little bit more so you can see it better. So while it's loading, you can see that there's like a little kind of triangle shape here. It's not quite a triangle because it's got the top of it cut off. And then you've got the wedge. So we call this the wedge and this the triangle. And so it's actually a pretty simple statics problem where you've got this wedge or this screw, sorry, fastener, that when you screw it, it's going to go in and out, obviously, it's a screw. And it's, so it's going to pull this wedge in and out, and that's just going to make this triangle slide up and down. So I think we did problems similar to that in statics, just saying that it's going to create an up and down force. So it's just translating this motion into up and down. So that allows us to clamp these into place so that if this one is maybe 1.7 millimeters, this card, and this one is 1.6, and maybe the next one is 1.5, we're really getting it in place. And we've got three of them, so if it's kind of wavy, it's you've got left, right, and center to really clamp it in based on what like features of that card are. So if it's not perfectly horizontal, flat, it can clamp it in place really well.
And if I can just jump in for a second, one of the, besides the what Katie's talking about with the tolerances on the printed circuit boards, we also really wanted a really good thermal interface to the frame because we didn't know what the thermal environment was going to be like. So we thought having everything thermally clamped to the frame would make sense to try and have everything be the same temperature. So there's ground planes in the circuit boards where the aluminum triangles and rails clamp together.
Yep. Yeah, so these are the same material as the frames. They're just a different color to make them stand out a little bit more. So, and they are very hard to make. Brian had some issues with that because they're very, very small. This SolidWorks doesn't really do justice to how small they are. And they are very difficult to put in. These sides are not the same length, but they look very similar when you're looking at one in person. So, yeah.
Excellent, thanks.
Yep.
Can I ask a question? And maybe you already answered it, but I'm wrangling children. What's the upside of doing this like sliding card method versus the stacked? Other than like, while it's still, you know, down here on Earth, I'm assuming assembling it and changing your cards around, but then once it's launched, like you're not really messing with it. Is there other benefits other than like assembly?
Yeah, so Andrew can talk more about it, but basically it's to, so our goal in terms of being an open source CubeSat for OreSat, we have like the two main missions, OreSat Live and CFC, but we also wanted to standardize a CubeSat so that anyone else can make one based on what we have. So you can see that we've got these empty slots, right? And so if someone else wanted to make the CubeSat, they could take our frames and put cards wherever they wanted. And then each student in particular could have their own card, and which is basically what we do. So one person can work on this card and one person can work on Star Tracker card, and they're all independent of each other instead of having some complicated mess. It's something that can really easily be changed as students graduate. They're all just a completely separate entity. So,
okay, yeah, that makes sense. Modularizing it.
yeah. So, it allows for freedom.
I'll just say one thing, which is that it's a good question because in space you don't care, and in fact there's drawbacks to doing a card cage like we've done here. And really, once they're in space, nobody cares that you have a card cage. So really, it's about the work on the ground. And that's one of the things that you don't think about often as a space program is you don't care because you've got, quote unquote, unlimited resources on the ground to do whatever you need to do. But with education, we've got a bunch of volunteers and we've got no money and we need the ability to swap things in and out. And we have teams that might may or may not do a card correctly or even work at all. And so this gives us the maximum flexibility while we do development, which is exactly what we want, because that's the hard part. Once you're in space, it's fine.
Okay.
Cool. Yeah, that makes a lot of sense.
Yeah. And yeah, there are some issues with it, some different things that you have to work around. From a mechanical standpoint, you've then got these posts which kind of get in the way for the cards, but then also in machining. I mean, most of us know that there's you can't really get very small fillets, so you can't have like straight corners, so everything has to be filleted a certain way, which is why we've got kind of these going on, and just some different issues with that, where you have one thing in mind and then you want it to be machined and they say no, we can't do that. And so it's definitely a give and take, and that is one of the first things that I did, was go in and change a bunch of fillets at 10 p.m. on Jitsi with Andrew. I remember it very well. But yeah. But that's also why we're doing this, is we're figuring out all the, smoothing out all the kinks so that whoever comes next can just make one much, much faster for much, much cheaper. And so we're doing all the versions so that someone else at some other small school that doesn't have a lot of funding can just make one of these and one frame, and then they can just go from there. So. So, yeah. Anything else anyone particularly wants to see? And then next week we can go into more detail about a certain sub-assembly if you guys want. So.
Yeah, I say we just start positive Z top to bottom, like each week, just kind of run through each section.
Yeah, sounds good. So, cool. One more thing. These solar panels. So the solar panel itself, the little blue one, is from Alta Devices. And basically, they have been in space once, I think. And so we get them for free, and then we're making the card. That's just another thing, since we're looking at the outside. And then we also have the version number on the side. And we have them labeled positive Y, minus X, all that good stuff. Cool. Okay. I think that's
thanks,
it.
Catie.
Yep.
Thank you, Catie.
Thank you.
Thank you.